Hello and welcome, adventurers, to Flying Orc. I am going through modules today, so I'm going to get straight into it. Basically, what we'll be discussing today is what a module is, how to install it, and how to utilize the module then once you have it installed. So very quickly, what a module actually is it's a modification. It's something that you add to your game to make your game improved or better in specific ways. Now, there are hundreds of modules. Some of them are premium and paid for. Most of them are free. Mostly the paid ones would be content packs and stuff that you may get from auxiliary websites. For example, I have the, I can actually show you just here. So if we go to premium, I have the Cobalt Press Tome of Beasts. There it is. Cobalt Press Tome of Beasts one. I purchased it from their website. I got a code. I put it in on the Foundry website and then I installed it. That's pretty much it. Now, I can happily do a guide on how to install premium content if anybody needs that. Just let me know in the comments. But for the moment, what I'll be focusing on is just mainly modules itself. Now, how it works is modules, for example, if I use Ammo Tracker as my example, okay? Ammo Tracker is a module that allows if anyone is a ranged character and they fire like 15 arrows, they don't want to keep track of those 15 arrows if combat's going on for a few hours. What'll happen is when I hit end combat, all my players who fired ammo will have a post in chat that goes up automatically saying reclaim half the ammo used. It tracks all the ammo for them. They just click that button and we just move on. And it saves so much time and so many questions of, can I have half my ammo back? Sure. How many did you fire? I think 15 or 20. I'm not sure. So it saves all of that. That's what I like about Foundry, is it really speeds up the little niche parts in between the narrative and the combat. I'm very narrative focused. I love my narrative and I love telling stories and I love sharing that experience and sharing the excitement of the combat and everything. And I don't want to spend a lot of time just doing the little bits. Foundry is amazing at dealing with prep and modules are exactly why. So if I go to install a module, I'll show you here and now how this works. So you click install module at the bottom. For this demo, we're going to be using Dice So Nice. So Dice So Nice, we can see it here at the top. You can click on this GitLab to see all the information about the module. They all have them. It's usually GitLab or GitHub. So we can install this here. You can see the blue bar at the bottom moving across. Dice So Nice was installed. And if I filter here, Dice So Nice, now installed, update. So you can click this lock to prevent it from uninstalling or update. You can uninstall the module to remove it or update it as well if you prefer. What we'll do is we'll jump into the game world now and I will show you how to use the module, how to install it and get it active. So the way it works is if we go to manage, go to your settings up at the top right here and then go to manage modules. We filter them, we go to Dice So Nice, and then you tick the modules that you want to use and you click save. It will refresh the application. That's perfectly normal. That happens usually, especially when you install a module or you activate a module, but also sometimes when you change module settings, which is worth keeping in mind. So what we can do is just, I'll show you very quickly here that this is now active and ready to go. So you go to configure settings here at the top, go to module settings, and Dice So Nice is the only module that I have. So it's the one at the top here. But if you've got a ton of modules installed, it may just appear in a list. So for example, I can make a bunch of changes here. Now I will be going over Dice So Nice amongst a ton of other modules anyway at some point. But for the moment, what I'd like to do is finish this Foundry 0 to 100 so that everybody can get their game set up. And then I'll explore more of these things like my personal suggestions and recommendations. But for now, with Dice So Nice, for example, if I go over here and I just say slash R 1d20 or 12d20, 1d20, we can see that my dice is this kind of lightning bolty colorful one. This is what I got from Dice So Nice in the past. So what I can do is go into my dice settings. If I change it to say poison and Foundry VTT, change it maybe to plastic so it looks a little bit different. Then I click save. I can do that same roll. If you press up in chat to get the previous message sent, you can do that. Click one. And now my dice is different. All my players will see my dice that way too. And they can do this themselves and then we'll see their dice too. And one of the great things about it is like you can have special effects if you get like a nat 20. For example, you can have these all these different things like a sound plays or blaze. Like I said, I'll go over it anyway, but just to show you the scope of what a module can actually do. For another example, if I open up my cart here, this is your like your standard page, which is totally fine. Oops. And if we go to settings and go to manage modules and we go to tidy sheet. So this is a module that I use very commonly. And if I save this, then I'll open my card again. I'll go to Sheet. It's already set the title vehicle. There you go. It already actually kicked in because I had it installed previously. So now this is what the new sheet looks like. And so what that basically does is just make everything more compact, tidy, and clean. And I like how it works and how it looks. There are also modules, for example, if you use D&D Beyond to download everything you have in D&D Beyond, or to if you're going to move from Roll20, for example. There are modules that allow you to import your entire Roll20 campaign. I used that when I moved from Roll20 about a year ago. I'm not sure if it's up to date anymore or if it still works, but it definitely did exist. That is something worth noting, that modules do get outdated sometimes, or that people drop support for them and they don't stay up to date with the current version. And as I said in my previous video about updating, when it comes to modules, you definitely want to make sure that the module is supported by the version before you update Foundry. Because it can be tedious and daunting, and I did get a comment like that in my previous video, where it is just a big task if you've got 15, 20 or more modules to just check that whole list and go through it and make sure everything's okay. And hopefully there will be support for that in the future, but for the moment it is worth making sure that your modules are actually ready and supported before doing a full client update, because otherwise the modules could end up breaking your game in some capacity, or worse, it could ruin the world in some ways, I'm sure, and you don't want any of that to happen. However, if you do see weird things happening, like for example, when I updated, I suddenly couldn't move my tokens. So what I had to do was go to Manage Modules and say, untick all of them, and then tick, you know, like five of them. And then when I did, I would click Save Module, it would refresh, and I'd go, okay, it's not happening, so I'd tick five more, and so forth. What you actually saw here as well is interesting. So when I clicked on these modules, what I'll do is I'll click No here for a moment. So if I click About Time, it tells me that it requires a dependency. FoundryVTT Simple Calendar is the dependency. So what I do is I click yes, and if I go to, I go to calendar, Simple Calendar is already ticked because it knows it needs that to run About Time. So there are sometimes modules that'll download and it says, oh, we need a dependency, and then you just tell it, okay, that's fine. It'll download the dependency as well for the actual compatibility of the module as well. Sometimes you'll even get modules that when you update them, it says that the URL has changed, the manifest URL. That's perfectly fine as well. That's not a problem. Sometimes developers will change where the download is located and they'll just tell Foundry to redirect to there. So you just click yes and it'll download the update for the module. Effectively, that's it when it comes to installing and operating modules. Just when you go to configure settings and module settings, you'll see all, like for example, with Dice So Nice, they have a ton of settings that you can do. Tidy Sheet is now here too, which again has a ton of different stuff. I can even switch this to dark mode, save my changes, open up my cart, and now it's a dark mode. Ooh, that's nice. Now it's a dark mode sheet. And so, like, you can see how modules can very quickly and effectively change your game. And I, like I said, I use like 70 or 80 modules, but I'm addicted, very addicted to modules. But I love how it incorporates itself into the game and becomes a much easier process. The benefit of Foundry, as I've said multiple times before, I'm sure, is that Foundry's prep work is what makes it so beautiful. You can prep so much and automate so much in Foundry. Like, I use MIDI QOL module, for example, to automate dice rolls and speed things up on my side. My players still get to roll their dice, but for me, if I click attack and click on the zombie claw, for example, it does its melee attack and it rolls for, it asks the player to roll its con save or whatever, you know. It does all of that automatically. The players still get to experience their part of it, the rolling the dice, and that it's not really the most tactile feel in the world because you're playing a virtual game, but it's the closest thing, still telling it to do what you want it to do, right? But for the DM, it definitely makes things a lot faster. I can do a lot of module reviews and guidelines, and if you have any questions, please ask them in chat. I'm more than happy to go through it, but realistically, that is all it is for modules at the moment. I will be going over maps pretty soon, about how to import maps and how to create items, that kind of thing. And then effectively, I'll be jumping into some more advanced module support. That's what I want to do for a little while once everything is done, about how to set up your game, so that I can show you what modules can realistically unlock and do for you. But for the moment, I hope this really helped you. If you have any questions or if you need any support, feel free to ask me in the comments below, and I'll do my best to help. Thank you for joining me today. Have a great day.